I'm Salvador Rivera in San Ysidro, California, overlooking the city of Tijuana, where recently ambulance service has gotten a whole lot better. And this is due in part to the work of engineering professors and students at the University of California, San Diego.
We're able to see, you know, where the ambulances are located in real time.
They came up with an app to make it easier for dispatchers south of the border to dispatch ambulances, make it faster, more efficient to get help to people in need. Dispatchers can also track units, know how many are available, and which ones are already on a call. This has really paid off in this current COVID-19 era. People driving the ambulance can let the hospitals know they are bringing in someone who appears to have the virus, and hospitals can be ready and waiting with the proper precautions. Salvador Rivera for theborderreport.com.
This is Sandra Sanchez in South Texas, where a 13-year-old girl was recently put on an expulsion flight and deported back to El Salvador by the Trump administration's new policy regarding the coronavirus pandemic designed to protect the southwest border. But according to a new lawsuit, this violated her rights. Several nonprofits filed the lawsuit in a federal court in Washington, D.C. against the federal government, charging that federal immigration laws require unaccompanied minors to be properly processed. Carla Vargas of the Texas Civil Rights Project told Border Report today that the girl entered South Texas on April 21st and fell into the Rio Grande after being chased by a Border Patrol canine. She was held at a McAllen station and then sent to a hotel for a few days, and then she was expelled on a deportation flight late one night. She had wanted to reunite with her mother, who is legally living in New York. The suit is one of the nation's first legal challenges to this new policy that the Trump administration began on March 20th on the U.S. Mexico border. For BorderReport.com in South Texas, I'm Sandra Sanchez.
This is Diego Sendez reporting from Juarez, Mexico. 3 months after the COVID-19 pandemic arrived at the U.S. Mexico border, officials on both sides of the Rio Grande are making plans for a phased in economic reopening. In El Paso, businesses are already operating at between 50 to 75% capacity. And today, the mayor of Juarez said his city could be given the green light for a phased-in reopening beginning next month. For more information, read my story on BorderReport.com.